Yeah. I got a couple of logical questions to ask. Don't worry, I got the answers at the end, but I just want you to pay attention. Don't check your brains at the door. Listen up. Yeah. Does it make sense for me to enter a prayer circle and say amen at the end when I didn't comprehend what they were saying? Was the Holy Spirit given to Christians so when the rhythm is quickening, he can hit them and get them shaking and wiggling? You're listening. If in the house of God has a forbidden, then how come the high priests weren't permitted without them? And furthermore, did the Lord say he dwell in the four walls or in the hearts of those he secures? Can I be blunt for a minute? If it's a sin to get drunk, then what kind of spirit makes you a fumbling idiot?
Consider this.
And when did it become known to the Holy Ghost to take control of folks and do things that the scriptures don't promote? And I hope you soak this in when you hear it. Am I supposed to be a sin offering if you slay me in the spirit?
Where did they get it?
And finally, whether it's rhyme to preach, are you dividing the word or trusting your heart that it's divine and sweet? No, I'm not beefing with any denominations, just relaying the questions of a confused congregation. And if possible, I'd like to give you some logical goggles with which to examine the epistles, prophets, and gospels. Specifically, 1 Corinthians 14:16, John 14-16, back to 1 Corinthians chapter 11, Acts 7, verses 48-50, to Titus chapter 2, 1-6, please. 1 Corinthians 14:40, Leviticus chapter 1 and 3 and 4, verse 4b and 15 and 24 and 29 and 33, and once again back to 1 Corinthians 14:40, 2 Timothy 2:15 and 1 Peter 3:15 and Jeremiah 17:9. It's time to rewind so you can write them down if you missed it. Acts 17:11, don't get it twisted.